Very good morning to one and all. I am Professor Dr. Nallisamy, Professor and Dean of Mechanical Engineering from Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute. So one of the autonomous deemed to be university in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, India. My research topic is design and analysis of epoxy granite reinforced with steel vertical machining center spindle housing. The aim of my research is to design the spindle housing made of epoxy granite reinforced with steel for a vertical machining center as a substitute for the currently used cast iron housing, with the aim of improving the dynamic performance and to increase the damping potential of the structure while retaining the stiffness properties. The methodology which is used in this research is a steel reinforced epoxy granite structure could be proposed for VMC spindle housing, and moreover the proposed model could be analyzed for the static structure considerations. In current industry scenario, the industries are nowadays focusing more on achieving high quality products only. Generally, machine tool structures are subjected to continuous distortion and unwanted vibrations during machining process. In order to resist these effects, the structures should have better dynamic properties. Hence, cast iron has been used as structural material for structures of machine tools in case of high-speed machining, high damping properties are required. The lack of desired dynamic properties results in dimensional inaccuracies in the components. Machining centers are one of the solutions which employ metal removing process to achieve high productivity and high quality. High damping properties and stiffness of the machine tools structures greatly influence the quality of the products. In machine tool, most of the components are made of cast iron as it possesses better dynamic response compared to other materials. So recently we are using only the cast iron for machine tool structures. So we are planning to change the cast iron into some other reinforced material. So the design of spindle housing in machine tool structures, all the structures including base, column, etc. encounter both bending and torsional loads. The base and column experiences load in a distributed manner, but the spindle housing sustains a point load at the tool tip. Also, the torsional load experienced by the spindle housing is higher than the other structures of the machine tool. Hence, the spindle housing are generally designed with higher stiffness. In this research work, the newly proposed composite spindle housing and cast iron spindle housing are analyzed for common force and boundary conditions to get the better results and to found which one is the best option to go for the structural materials. The levels of forces and periphery, we have been analyzed the structure of the structure by using ANSYS, the software of ANSYS R18. Based on the figure which is shown in the slide, the ball screw mount at the back side of the spindle housing is considered as the fixed support. The surfaces on which the linear motion pad are to be mounted are considered directional supports along the X and Y directions. The cutting force for worst case machining conditions is estimated and applied at the tool tip. The magnitudes of the components of forces in each force configuration of machining, such as X, Y axis milling, Z axis for drilling, are listed and the results are tabulated in the following table. Since the component, the forces are X, Y and Z, where the magnitude which has been observed in x-axis feet, the magnitude is 2350, and the y axis is 850 and z axis 1300. Similarly, for y axis speed, component x force is 850 and y force is 2350 and z force is 1300. As far as z axis speed is concerned, x component is comes under 0 and y components comes under 0 and the z component forces comes under 2500. The cast iron spindle housing, normally we have taken the spindle housing of 6 different design configurations of DC1 to DC6 made of cast iron have been considered. These 6 configurations are made with the consideration of manufacturing flexibility through casting process. In design configuration 1, the across ribs inside the spindle housing are made referring to the existing cast iron spindle housing. Normally, the circular ribs along vertical axis are to be introduced to reduce stress concentration in the spindle housing. In case of design consideration 2, is similar to DC1 but added with features like fillets, chamfers and circular structures at the joints for stress reduction. So here all the 6 cast iron structures which has been created are shown in the figure. So the deformation for cast iron spindle housing has been calculated. That has been given in the table following table. The DC1 total deformation for DC1 is 41 and DC2 is 14, DC3 is 14, DC4 is 65, DC5 is 77, and the total deformation is for DC6 is 51 micrometer. In DC3, the front end of the spindle housing is designed with curved edges as the sharp edges experience higher stress. DC4, DC5 and DC6 are provided with the slotted side plate structures and horizontal ribs for improving the stiffness. The 6 configurations of cast iron spindle housing are analyzed for structural loads and the results are tabulated. From the tabulated results, it can be seen that the minimum deformation achieved in 14 microns, and this has been taken as the benchmark value, and the permissible deformation in the composite spindle housing is considered to be 14 microns for all the deformations. Composite structure of epoxy granite steel housing. This is our proposed composite structure. In the composite epoxy granite steel spindle housing, the steel reinforcing structure placed inside epoxy granite housing should be designed in such a way that it withstands all the loads acting on the housing without the deformation exceeding the set limit. The epoxy granite over the steel reinforcement would provide damping to the variations during machining. To obtain the optimized steel reinforced structure topology, optimization is used. The topology optimization of steel reinforcement for spindle housing, that to develop a block structure is analyzed for static performance, and then using the topology optimization tool, the locations where additional material is required is highlighted. Similarly, the various structures have been analyzed, and we are going for steel reinforcement structure design also. The deformation results of initial configuration of reinforcement due to the cutting force are listed in table, and it can be seen that the deformation is very much higher than the permissible value. That the deformation value for the different ratios and desired effect of reinforcement are given in the table. Whereas the DC7 is made with I section beam at the center along with the y-axis. The support rods are added in an inclined manner between the corner of support plate and I-beam at a position close to spindle. The description of the reinforcement desired effect on the structure due to reinforcement and influence of the structure on the deformation and the directional and the resultant deformations of the D7 to D12 are given are tabulated. These are the results of deformation for D7 to D12, whereas from the results we are going for the we are going to shoot out the appropriate design. In case of composite epoxy granite steel structure, the steel reinforcement will be embedded inside the epoxy granite model mold such that steel provides stiffness and the epoxy granite provides damping to the variation vibrations. The configurations of steel reinforcement with exhibited better structural performance are placed inside the epoxy granite housing structure with 25 mm wall thickness, and the composite structure is analyzed for the static structural conditions. The analyzed structure of the epoxy granite with steel configurations is shown in the following shown in the next figure, and the results of the machining configuration results are given in the table. The composite spindle housing design for DC13 has been analyzed for the deformation, and the results are given in the table. The results of the structural analysis shows that the maximum deformation of the steel reinforced epoxy granite spindle housing is found to be less than 10 microns. When compared with the cast iron housing, the values of the deformation are much lower in our proposed steel reinforced epoxy granite spindle housing. See, these are the main conclusions based on our research and analysis. The initial reinforcement design of DC1 has been arrived at from the topology optimization. The addition of reinforcement to the initial steel structure of DC1 has been reduced deformation from 230 microns to 6 microns in the improved steel reinforcement structure of DC13. The reinforcement with I section in the epoxy granite is found to resist deformation than other reinforcements. The improved steel reinforced epoxy granite spindle housing design possesses better stiffness compared to the cast iron spindle housing. Hence, the improved I section steel reinforcement epoxy granite spindle housing is more suitable than the cast iron spindle housing. Hence, we can suggest instead of cast iron spindle housing, better we can go for the improved I section steel reinforcement epoxy granite spindle with steel, which is having more stiffness and more mechanical properties, and this can be suggested for the future references. Thank you, one and all.